All right, here we are with another one interview. This is Jacob Whiteside.
Hello, everybody.
We're in the Chicago Theater, historic theater.
No, I'm so pumped. Everyone's been talking about how thrilled they are to play tonight. I've never been here, so I'm
How was soundcheck? How was the acoustics?
So nice.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan of the reverb, and this room is just so big and fat, and it sounds incredible.
Lots of iconic people have played here.
I know.
A lot of history. Maybe some ghosts for Halloween.
I'm actually abnormally scared of like ghosts.
Are you really?
In the dark and stuff like that. Yeah.
Oh my gosh, that's gonna be one of my questions. Favorite scary movie.
What is my favorite scary movie?
Scary.
I love the Purge movies.
The Purge. Those are good though. Because
they're real life.
They're grounded in reality.
Exactly.
Right? Yeah. Okay, so you grew up in Knoxville? Is that right? In Tennessee. So we're fellow Tennesseans. I grew up in Tennessee and Hendersonville.
Absolutely.
Okay.
It's Middle Tennessee, right? It's not East.
Right. It's Middle. Right. Exactly. Good. This guy.
I'm trying to get my geography down.
So, did you always want to be a singer?
No. Not at all. I actually was so into sports. From first grade up to eighth grade, until I was 13, I was playing football, basketball, running track, playing tennis, doing all the sports I could get my hands on. And, eventually, I was forced to go to this concert that I didn't want to go to. It was a bluegrass festival, and ended up going and really falling in love with music that day. It was just a special day. It was bluegrass. So I mean, the songwriting and stuff was just out of this world. Super sad song. I remember that was my first time ever really crying in public. Mm-hmm. I was sitting watching the band, and it was so emotional, and it was a touching day. So that's kind of when I decided I was gonna go a different route.
So, but you haven't done bluegrass, right?
No, I have not.
But is it a secret?
I would love to. It'd be so fun. I would love to do bluegrass versions of all my songs.
Yeah.
I actually love bluegrass. I love going to bluegrass festivals now. I just did not have a deep appreciation for country bluegrass music when I was 13.
I would think of Dolly Parton because she does bluegrass.
She's phenomenal.
She's amazing.
She's from my hometown. I grew up in Sevierville, Pigeon Forge.
Sevierville, right? The hills. Did you have a Cookman in Colors? Tell me you did.
But my mom's mom went to school in Dolly.
Oh, really?
Yeah, small town.
Now that is cool. Have you been in Dollywood, obviously?
Yes, 100 times. I get season passes every year.
Yeah.
Even when I'm on tour. I go twice, get my money back.
That Eagle one is really fun.
Oh my gosh. Does and they cool? They just released the fastest wooden roller coaster in the world as well.
Oh, so Dolly's really great. I've been able to interview her a few times.
Really?
Yeah, she's good. I just saw her. But we could just talk about Dolly the whole time. But we don't have to. But you came out of X Factor, right? That's kind of
where I got my start. I mean, I didn't get much exposure from the show, but that was my first real music related thing that I did. It was a really good, more than anything, it was a really awesome learning experience, watching the different routes everyone took after they got off the show or if they won the show, and making mental notes as a 14-year-old who didn't know much about the music industry. It was a nice learning experience.
Yeah, it's kind of make it or break it at that time.
Absolutely,
right?
Absolutely.
Yeah. And now they're coming back, I think, right?
I think so. I love X Factor. That's my guilty pleasure.
That's a great show. Well, I had your favorite. Okay, so I want to do some Whiteside questions.
All right.
Questions on the side. But I just wanted to kind of know a little bit about you. Do you have a favorite musical? Anything like that?
I've never seen a musical.
Oh my gosh, Hamilton's right down the street. So you gotta go to Hamilton.
Oh my gosh. I was actually in Connecticut right when I was starting to write my album. My manager got front row for Hamilton.
Oh.
And he was said it was the most incredible thing he's ever seen. So
oh.
I definitely want to go. I just have never been in New York City or Chicago or anything.
Yeah.
For
we gotta get you to a
long enough amount of time.
Favorite fast food?
I think it's a pretty close tie between Chipotle and Chick-fil-A.
Okay.
My two favorites.
All right. Chick-fil-A is right down.
I live walking distance from both of them, so I just walk every day. I don't have a car in Nashville, so I just walk to both of them.
Okay.
I just alternate every day.
You don't have a car in Nashville? That's kind of interesting.
I know. Well, I'm not home enough to drive, so I'd rather just Uber every once in a while.
Oh, okay. Good. Do you have a favorite movie? I know we talked about The Purge, but all-time favorite.
All-time favorite. I really love space movies. I really loved The Martian and Interstellar. Those are my two favorite movies recently.
The Martian
was
good.
Yeah,
really
we rewatched that the other day on the bus. It's
that's a good one.
Stressful.
Okay, so let's talk about Lovesick.
Yeah.
Just such a great song.
Thank you. Yeah, Lovesick was the first record that we recorded on the entire album. We were up in Connecticut, kind of talking about the vision for the record and kind of deciding the sounds that we wanted to do, and really just ultimately trying to decide how we were going to find the perfect mix between like the Bones, which was like the singer-songwriter type stuff, the stuff I grew up listening to, like John Mayer and James Taylor, and kind of mixing that with some new pop stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And the guys from Magic sent over a rough demo for this Love for Love's Sake, and we fell in love with it. We ended up flying back to Nashville, flying them in from LA, and spent 3 days with them, wrote a couple other songs I made on the album, and it was a really fun experience. That was my first time ever writing with like other like, I'm not gonna say another artist, but like another kind of well-known artist.
Mm-hmm.
So it was a really fun experience being able to hang out with them, and they're Canadians, and they're like the nicest people in the
They
entire
are really,
world.
I have met them. They're very
so
nice.
Sweet.
I met them on a red carpet. They're super nice. So why do you call your album Why?
Oh my gosh, I feel like Why was just, at the time it was a question that I wasn't asking myself enough, and it was almost like a reminder for me, because I go through life and I'm doing so many different things all the time, and I never like question, you know, what certain situations enough, and I kind of really wanted to take a step back and kind of be more self-reflective for a couple of the tracks on this album, and kind of the general vibe of the album was just being kind of reflective of all the things that were going on in my life and in my relationship. So
mm-hmm.
I feel like Why kind of summed up, and the song was kind of a breaking point as well, and it was kind of a peak in the album. So it was definitely, and I wanted to have a question mark in my album title.
Oh yeah, so you don't see that too much.
Yeah.
So I watched the video for Focus. Was that confetti being thrown on your head, or what was
Yes,
that?
it was a feather confetti
mix.
Yeah,
oh,
it was homemade in the studio. It was really, that video was a blast. It was actually, we did it really quick. We practiced it like 8 times all the way through, and tried not to make a mess on those takes. And then
okay.
we did like 2 actual takes, and we got it on the first one.
Wow.
And it was all one take. There was no editing in it besides like the visual effects. Like there was no cuts or anything. So it was really fun, and it was really challenging focusing on the camera the entire time. Because if you watch the video, I don't break eye contact with the camera the entire. Despite all the things going on.
Stuff's getting dumped on you.
Snake.
Yeah, you took Britney's snake. Britney's here, snake. I've seen that snake.
I snatched it.
Were you scared of the snake?
Deathly. I was deathly afraid
yeah,
of the snake. That's why. That's kind of why I did it, because I wanted to conquer a fear in the video. I feel like that'd be the ultimate distraction, was having it. I think it was a 35 or 40 pound snake around my neck.
So, oh my god.
And it was
brave.
It was scary. I actually really enjoyed it once I kind of did it a couple times and kind of got the general. The scariest part is just trying to really hold it without like it like moving at all. It was just,
I got the chills.
Once I got comfortable, it was all right.
Yeah, I don't know if I ever
initially seeing it, I was ready to throw up.
Yeah. So Open Book's your latest song,
yes.
Right? So like, what do you want people to know about you as an artist?
Oh my goodness.
You know, this is your time to be an open book.
Oh my gosh. If people can know anything about me as an artist, it'd probably be that I've been doing this for a hot minute. I feel like a lot of people feel like it was kind of a really quick thing, but I'm only 18, but I've been doing this since I was 13, and before I even did the whole social media thing, I was playing in bars and doing open mic nights with my dad for like a year and a half straight, where I was going in and setting up all the PA system and really working for like a solid 4.5 hours in like the heat, and
mm-hmm.
Kind of, I feel like a lot of people don't know that side of my story, the fact that I kind of started off before social media in these ratchet bars.
And you couldn't even really stay after and drink, right?
No, absolutely not. Not at 13. I was barely allowed in. It was like
yeah.
21 and up clubs.
Like
I'm like sneaking in with a wig on.
Wow. So I saw you perform at Subterranean here in Chicago.
Oh, nice.
So I went to your show, and I think people really need to see you live. Because
I hope so.
You really put on a show.
Thank you. Thank you.
Know,
are you staying for the show tonight?
Yeah.
Heck
yeah.
I'm playing some of the new tracks from the album. So
oh, good.
That was like my last tour with the old songs. We played a couple of them, but I've got mainly new songs in the set. So
you were really too big for Subterranean. I mean, honestly.
Thank you. It was one of the first shows to sell out on the tour. So I was really the support I've had in Chicago has just been unreal. It's
yeah.
been amazing, and I know I'm not just saying this because I'm here, but Chicago is my favorite city.
It's yeah.
Beautiful and clean and spacious and
good.
Awesome.
I'm glad you're out.
Besides when it's winter. When I'm freezing.
Yeah, right.
I thought I could like I came here like middle of winter one time and I was like, oh, I'll just throw on like a hoodie and like some nice sweatpants.
Mm-hmm.
And I came outside and I I literally thought I was gonna cry. It was so cold. My bones were like aching.
Yeah, not too bad today though.
No, it was beautiful.
Yeah. So you, I mean, you have like tons of girls. I mean, just these girls go crazy over you. They're with their mothers.
I don't know why. I haven't figured it out.
Oh yeah, he's so humble. Yeah, and I know there's a lot of gay fans too. I was
yes, it's incredible. Like, and more so. I feel like they're getting more and more comfortable coming to my shows and. A lot of my fans, girl and guy, have come out to me and have brought their girlfriends and boyfriends, and it's incredible. It makes me so happy that they're getting more comfortable. I feel like with social media, it's making especially youth so much more comfortable with coming out about that kind of stuff, and
yeah.
and people are so much more open-minded. I feel like with the internet now in general, that it's so much easier, especially in like smaller towns where in the past, all you would know is what your parents told you and what the people around you told you. And now with social media, you're able to kind of form opinions outside of your general little area. So I feel like it's making everyone so much more comfortable with coming out about all kinds of different things. And it's been wonderful being able to kind of help some of my fans through that.
Yeah, great. We need to get you at some festivals and stuff like that.
I would love to.
You know, we have
except I have a little bit of social anxiety, so. Festivals are a little.
Not on stage though, Jake. We have to say, you seem very comfortable on stage.
Thank you.
And I mean, you must hide it very well because you are.
I feel
really
a little
good.
More comfortable when it's just my fans.
Okay.
That's like another level of reassurance, but when I'm doing opening stuff, I'm a little bit more nervous.
Yeah.
But it's gotten better on this tour. Like, it's a different demographic out there. It's like older college kids and like parents and stuff. And so that's been an interesting kind of. Getting more comfortable like singing to them because it's not kind of a screaming freakish crowd.
Yeah.
They're kind of more relaxed, which is nice. It's been really cool.
Yeah.
But it's definitely been kind of scary to be used to.
Right. Well, so when are you coming back to Chicago? Do you know? Or
I don't know. I mean, I'll probably be back here. I think I'm doing. I know I'm doing Europe February through March, and then I'm trying to go to Australia and Asia.
Okay.
Do some shows, and then after that, I should be doing either a co-headline or a headline tour in the U.S. again. So.
Okay.
Soon. It should be like after March, sometime mid next year.
Okay. So where do you want people to follow you and all that stuff? Do you have any secret names?
Oh man. I mean, besides Jacob Whitesides is pretty much across the board.
Anywhere?
Except my Snapchat is Jacob on tour, but I'm pretty lame on there, so don't go at scary stuff.
Yeah, you have a website.
Yes, jacobwhitesides.com. So all my links are on there. If you can't find any of my other ones, you can go on there. Buy tickets to shows or get VIP or join my fan club or whatever you want to do.
Mm-hmm. You should have more fans.
I hope so.
Yeah, I mean.
I feel like I'm getting close. I feel like this last album that I just dropped recently has brought in a lot of new ears and it's been really refreshing because I was playing the same songs for so long and bringing in a fresh new pair of songs and seeing new faces in the crowd. It's just been like, it's really reassuring as an artist being able to drop something and feel like you're gaining momentum. So,
great.
It's been beautiful.
Awesome. Well, thanks for a beautiful interview.
Thank you so much.
It's been like really great to get to know you a little bit. I think this is, you know, really important.
This is our first time talking, right? I'm not
yeah.
crazy. All right,
no, this is our first time. I tried to get
sometimes
you last time.
Sometimes I'm a little brain dead.
But it worked out well that I went and saw you at Subterranean first, and now, you know, we're seeing a different way. So
absolutely.
So very
good
excited.
To talk to you.
Thank you so much.
Thank y'all for watching.
All right, thanks.